band in England right now, and they are hoping to duplicate their success on this side of the Atlantic. So far, their Ant Music has been winning over thousands of fans, selling concerts out and selling record stores out as well. All of us on the show have been anticipating this moment all week long. With a song called Ant Music, would you please welcome Adam. Please welcome back, without the ants this time, here is Adam. And thank you for looking for us. How can you possibly live up to all the advanced billing that has come preceding your arrival here and measure up to the expectations so many people have for your success here? It seems to me that you're under an awful lot of pressure.
I think you quite simply just stop talking, put your clothes on, and get out and play for people. Mm-hmm. Very simply.
Had a man here last week, Ted Nugent. No doubt you've heard of him, Mr. Nugent. Now easy, fans, hold on.
I watched it.
All right. Now, we talked a little bit, and he came down pretty hard on drugs, and he came down pretty hard on liquor.
I agree.
And in reading about you this afternoon, I know that you like to play places where young people can come where they don't serve alcoholic beverages.
Yeah.
Are we seeing, in your view, the beginning of a new kind of rock star or musical star that has a little bit of morality and feels a little responsibility towards the audiences?
I hope so. I watched Ted Nugent. I agreed with everything he said. I'm personally... I in England about 2 years ago, I just saw some young people very into drugs, you know. It's a very old story. I just think that it's 20 years old now, you know. Mm-hmm. And the whole rock and roll lifestyle is just, I don't know, it's very old-fashioned. It's very dated now. And I don't think it doesn't look after your body or your spirit. Mm-hmm. So it's just fresh.
At one time, and again, I only know this from reading about you, it was said that you were a punker, that was your style of music.
I don't know what to do. No.
Have you made a change in the direction somewhere along the line?
No, I believe that the word punk was not only meaningless, but a term that was never actually accurately interpreted. By the time the Sex Pistols, who were the forerunners of that particular movement, were national property on TV, it was all finished. It was a very tiny, very elitist movement, styled, mainly a revolting style rather than anything else.
When you say elitist, how was it elitist?
It was very small, it was like a club, really. Mm-hmm. A very tiny collection of people, for instance, Marco was involved in it. But basically, it was drawn together by people who enjoyed similar types of music they couldn't hear anywhere else, and clothes, and a look, really, and being told you didn't have to be a heavy group or a super group to play on stage. But all the politics side of it was always nonsense, and I don't like politics in music.
All right. Now, there are words that run through the subculture of Adam and the Ants, words like ant music, sex people. Yeah. Can you define those terms for me?
Well, they were given to me by the audience primarily. I've been using them for about 2 years now. Ant music really is, we name our own music ant music to prevent classification mm-hmm. and bracketing from other people. I don't think that's pretentious considering it's taken 4 years to get the sound. Sex people is just purely, you know, kids wrote me letters saying that they, when they dress up, I think part of dressing up and part of fashion, the basic essence of it, is a very pure sex, a very pure, enjoyable form of sex, an innocent form, not a kind of decadent taboo side, a very fresh thing. I think it can be utilized very, very well by young people.
All right. How did you pick the name Adam and the Ants?
It was purely accidental, really. I always liked ants, because there was this other group a few years back. Yeah, it was something like that. And they're small, they're tough, they stick together, and they're supposed to be intelligent. I hope we're all of that. Mm-hmm. I would hope.
And the pirate costumes?
Oh, it's these are just themes of clothes that the lyrics of the songs come from, choosing heroic and romantic savagery, you know, romantic kind of themes. Rather than, I don't know, Western ones, you know, modern ones. I think that every part of it represents a culture that's very, I think, noble. I think tribal music is very noble. I think tribal society is very noble. I think it has values that we could learn a lot from.
And there was something very noble and glamorous about the days when Britannia ruled the seas, huh? The pirates of days gone by?
I don't know about that. That's a bit empire status for me. I don't know, you know. I like the fact that people are proud of their, you know, their particular countries and their cultures and their history. I think that's a good thing.
I thank you for being here tonight.